Okay, so the other problem that we have is, especially if you're a new student in a new lab and they've given you access to this nice space and they've given you the right permissions, is there's a bunch of files and there's no explanation of what these are. And if you've run any bioinformatic program, you will know there's lots of temporary files that get generated. There's only one output file that matters and everything else is stuff the computer needs or the program needs, but you don't necessarily need. So what do you do in that case? Like, what are all these files? What am I looking at? And the solution is README. And be good about this. I have learned this through several failures. I've always had to go back to projects that I've not had readmes on and don't know what these files are. In every directory you have, ideally, I know that's a lot of work, have a readme file that explains what this directory is about, why it was generated, who made it, the purpose of it, and some contents with like the list of files that's in this and what they contain, like what information do they contain, which project, anything else that you think is important. Some of the big ones actually is the file names that I like, that I think is super important, is because at that point we give a short form or initial and then we say, okay, this is HWW_ some species, which of course you don't want to write the whole species out. So I work with microbes a lot. So like Vibrio cholerae is always BC. And then I'll just like list everything out. And if I don't have a metadata file where I explain what each of that is, a year from now or even a month from now, I won't remember what those are. And I think a good example that Kerry and Sherry like to give here is the male and female drain flies.
So we were given data from male and female flies of Drosophila melanogaster and Drosophila cunegris. So it's MM, MF, FM, FF. And it's like, we had no idea which were the males, which were the females, and which was the species. Oh, we did it wrong, and then we figured it out.
Yeah.
Kind of post-production, you know, because nothing made sense. We had to go back to the guy and like, last email you gave, that
wasn't right. So that's a good point to remember when you're doing this, have a README, especially if you're sharing the file with somebody else, make sure you have a README. That's important. And I think that's what I do. I don't have READMEs for everything I have on my scrap space. When I'm starting to archive them, I make it a point to actually write down everything, what it's done, what files are there. Document who to contact, which is very important. Include all the contents. The versions of software is very important. You know that there's always new softwares coming up. So if you run this entire script on a particular software, mention that. Because sometimes the newer software won't produce the same results and then everything's like that. Anything else that you think is important, and I promise it will save your sanity. And since we work on a lot of collaborative projects, trust me, we send out results and about a year later they're like, we're writing this paper now. Can you tell us what you did? And if you don't have this README, we have to go back and redo all of it. And this is months and months of work. That's not fun. Okay.